Greetings, travelers. Today, I'm going to learn you how to play Scholar in Final Fantasy XIV. It's not easy being a mediocre Scholar player. It takes an average amount of commitment and a normal amount of work. But as you can see by this parse, I am firmly in the 50%... Firmly in the 50% of Scholar players. To start your journey into mediocrity, it is important to catch up on your Final Fantasy XIV healing lore. When looking at the other healers, White Mage is considered the sadistic healer because they build up nutrients for their blood lily by healing people. And while Astrologian is the dual master, Scholar is very much the masochist of the healers. This is because Scholars are known for having to shield mechanics preemptively. Unfortunately, unlike our dual master brethren, we do not have the luxury of being able to see into the future, meaning we have to memorize everything in a fight rather than simply reacting to it. And we are rewarded by doing the least amount of damage of all the healers. First, unlocking Scholar is a difficult task. You must start by playing Arcanist, a thinking man's DPS. Once you level to 30, instead of unlocking the conventional job of summoner, you'll instead go to Gridania and unlock Codger. Oh wait, what I meant to say is that once you have access to Ishgard, you can unlock Astrology. Oh wait, that's right. You unlock Scholar in the lower decks of Limsa Lominsa. However, you will notice that you have been playing DPS for the past 30 levels. Now you must switch your mindset over to healer. To get started, let's focus on the most important thing as a scholar. Just like all other wild animals, our first instinct is survival. There's an interesting mechanic in Final Fantasy XIV, which is that if you don't stand in AoEs, you won't take any damage. I'd recommend trying to avoid taking any damage from these harsh abilities in the wild, as they will make your life more difficult. In any 4-man content, you will likely be the only resource to revive party members, and if you screw up a mechanic, you will single-handedly be responsible for wiping your entire party. While you might think this will tap into our masochistic nature, much like in the real world, even though we like hurting ourselves, we don't like hurting others. Ideally, our sacrifice will be made at the end of our content when we are no longer needed, discarded on the side of the road. Thankfully, our journey is not always lonely, as we have two different fairy companions. Choose whichever hairstyle you like, as they do the exact same thing. If you're new to the healing role, I recommend either looking up an instance ahead of time, or simply say that you're new to an instance, and let players passive-aggressively explain things to you in a condescending manner. Oh yes, daddy. Also, learn what a stack marker looks like and a spread marker. Also, click on your party members using the list of party members on the side instead of trying to click on them in a pack of mobs. The sooner you get used to instantly clicking on your tank, the sooner you can be an average healer. Once you are confident that you can at least anticipate absurd mechanics, you might be ready to learn the buttons. But first, let's have a word from our sponsor. Hello, I'm sponsoring my own video. If you enjoyed this average content, be sure to subscribe. Or if you really want to make my PP hard, you can always follow me on Twitch, where I make content without this stupid voice and have no video editing effort put into it. Thank you, and God bless you. Alright, firstly, at level 45 you unlock Aetherflow. Be sure to hit this button every minute and use all three of your Aetherflow stacks before that minute runs out. Legends say that for every second that goes by without an Aetherflow recast, a party wipes an Aurum Veil. These stacks are used on 5 different off-global cooldown skills. If you are new to the terms global cooldown and off-global cooldown, notice that some skills will not allow you to cast skills for around 2.5 seconds, while others don't put this restriction on your abilities. Your goal is to try to keep this 2.5 second recast timer ticking as much as possible. While leveling, it's best practice to get used to using your instant cast global cooldowns whenever you're about to cast an off-global cooldown. Your instant cast global cooldowns, or whatever your damage over time skill is called at any level, ruin 2 and Art of War. Remember, you can fit 2 off-global cooldowns between 1 global cooldown, with proper internet connection to the server. When simply damaging in one spot without movement needed, or needing any off-GCDs, you should be using either Ruin or Broil, or whatever your cast time damage skill is, called at your level for all damage phases. Luckily for Scholar, our AoE skill, which is the damage skill that you use if you ever fight more than 2 enemies at once, is also instant cast, allowing for even more off-GCD casting. Now, for reference, at level 80, all the following abilities are off-global cooldown. This will include Whispering Dawn, Fey Illumination, Aetherflow, Lustrate, Energy Drain, Sacred Soil, Excogitation, Indomitability, Deployment Tactics, Emergency Tactics, Lucid Dreaming, Swift Cast, Sure Cast, Dissipation, Chain Stratagem, Aether Pack, Recitation, Fey Blessing, Summon Seraph, and Consolation. So if you thought there was no way that weaving off GCDs was going to be something you were going to do, you were very wrong. The sooner you learn how to weave with your instant cast skills, the sooner you can plateau at mediocrity. Now you are probably wondering why this class needs to weave so much. However, if you look into the lore of the Weaver class, you will learn that it is all about suffering. Starting to see how everything is connected? Good. Now, we are ready to begin leveling. When running dungeons, your tank is most likely going to try to pull as many mobs as they can from the window to the wall. And as the sweat drips down your balls, in this case, it is fine to dedicate most of your time to healing. Be careful, because spamming Aldoquium is most likely going to drain your mana very quickly. It will only give us the Big Daddy Shield if you manage to crit heal with it. Be sure to counter this by spamming our Puny Physic whenever you see your mana dropping faster than my parents' expectations, and by using Lucid Dreaming around the time you drop below 50% mana. Use those Aetherflow stacks on Lustrate while weaving in between Art of War for maximum normal scholar behavior. Also for big pulls, using Sacred Soil is the hidden technique of scholar players, giving your tank a 10% damage reduction while also giving them some fat regen. Be sure to use Whispering Dawn for that extra regen as they go incredibly far when pulling trash packs, giving them that excogitation for some AFK healing action, and you have yourself a nice plate of pasta. However, if your tank decides to pull small, or if you're in a boss fight, this is where that Arcanist experience can really be put to use. It's time to become the worst DPS of all the healers. We spam our cast time GCD damage skill for 99% of combat, and when you either want to use your dot or rune 2 to try to weave in those off-global cooldowns. If you want to deal some average damage, you can start weaving Energy Drain after your Ruin 2. At level 60, we gain the ability to eat our fairy for 3 more Weaver Flow stacks to weave even more Energy Drains into our damage rotation. At level 66, we'll unlock Chain Stratagem, which you will use on cooldown on bosses to give your team a critical chance buff. This cooldown must be managed in addition for maximum worst healing DPS. In total, make sure your dot is always active, make sure you don't miss Aetherflow, don't miss your Crypts buff, don't miss your mealtime, and don't miss that Lucid Dreaming to keep up on your mana. All these cooldowns are needed to be a middle-of-the-road scholar player. Now you're probably overwhelmed just looking at all these abilities and wondering how you're going to manage them. Don't worry, the game will give you these tools very slowly so that nothing overwhelms you. Here are some good tricks though to help you in your journey. Use Recitation to guarantee a big shield on your tank while doing big pulls. Use Emergency Tactics to turn your shield heals into normal heals when your memory fails you on a mechanic. Use that Fey Illumination and Sacred Soul for some extra mitigation, and save that Swift Cast to raise people in content with random players. Don't forget to Essena anytime you see a spooky red debuff on anyone, and Sure Cast will also give you knockback immunity. Lastly, it's time to talk about raising your pet. The fairy, much like your party members, will never really want to listen to what you have to say. The fairy will slowly heal the lowest party member automatically as long as they are in range. When you want to use any of your fairy skills, such as Whispering Dawn or Fey Illumination, your fairy is going to take a random amount of time before actually casting that move. Make sure not to rely on them to be too speedy, and make sure that the cast is complete before you eat them. Otherwise, you're going to waste that cooldown and look like an idiot and cause your team to wipe to a mechanic because you didn't meet the heal check, and everyone looks down on you because you don't know how to play healer properly, and I'm sorry, okay? It happens. I swear I know what I'm doing. Use your pet hotbar to put the fairy in the middle of the battlefield and leave it there for most of the battle. You'll have to put it back after you eat it, though. Lastly, don't forget about Big Fairy, which we get at level 80. Big Fairy, almost as strong as Big Lion, will give enhanced healing and shielding, and will also let you cast Consolation, which is an off-GCD global shield cooldown. Will also delete your skills if Seraph returns too early, so make sure not to wait until the end of Big Fairy if you are to use your Whispering Dawn or Fey Illumination. And finally, use that Aether Pack to make your fairy have some significant healing and go back to cooking up that boss with Broil. With that, I have given you the ingredients. It is up to you to become a mediocre pasta maker. So go out there and show the community what it means to slap the ground with Art of War and weave those off GCDs. Now let's get out there and meet some expectations.